This is really interesting. I guess the fact that we have these three buckets, the number of critical resources, the number of critical bytes, and the path lengths, illustrate that there's really no one golden rule. For example, if I eliminate the number of critical resources, I would also probably reduce the number of bytes. And likewise, if I start compressing, caching, and minifying, I could also reduce the number of bytes.
Exactly. I couldn't have said it better myself. I think you're really starting to get a hang of this. Let's try a few more examples.
Okay, same page, but now with CSS and JavaScript. Once again, we get the HTML and discover CSS and JavaScript resources and initiate those requests. Note that the JavaScript file is a bit smaller than the CSS, so it may arrive sooner.
But JavaScript is blocked on the CSS on being created, right?
Correct. Once the CSS arrives, the browser builds the CSS object model, which unblocks JavaScript and allows it to execute. Once the JavaScript is executed, the DOM parser becomes unblocked, which means a complete DOM construction. And finally, we have both the DOM and the CSS object model, which means that we can render the page. As you can see, even a simple page such as this one has a lot of dependencies that slow down the critical path.
Yeah, no kidding.